The Indian Predator is one of the most popular Indian docu-series on Netflix. The series has brought out the little-known stories of the most heinous criminals from the history of our country. After the release and success of the first two seasons, the platform released the teaser of the third, and the third part has got everyone hooked. But what is the reason? Referred to as the Beast of Bengaluru City, this story is of a police official with a weird fetish for women's undergarments, who went on a raping spree all across the country. He was caught multiple times but managed to escape the prison on most of the occasions. This is the Umesh Reddy story, one of the most feared criminals in the history of Bengaluru. Born in 1969, Umesh is a Karnataka by birth. One of his first professional commitments was with the Central Reserve Police Forces. Yes, the CRPF. And that is when he started to unleash the devil inside him. As a CRPF guard on duty, Reddy attempted to rape the commandant's daughter. Following this case, he left the Kashmir valleys and returned back to his home state, Karnataka. Years later, Umesh got reinstated in uniform, this time as a district armed reserve police, as the officials there weren't aware of his acts in the prior job. After resuming services with the local police, Reddy began to rape and kill women of all ages. Reddy usually targeted housewives when their husbands would not be at home, that is between 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Umesh Reddy would reportedly enter the house asking for water, threaten the women to strip, and eventually rape them. There were also reports which suggested that Umesh raped several women even when they were unconscious and sometimes even when they were dead. After killing the victims, Reddy would steal their jewelry and undergarments, as he was later found out to be a transvestite, an individual who conducts the practice of dressing up with the clothes of the opposite gender. In 1996, Reddy was caught after a girl recognized him in a Republic Day parade. Umesh's tryst with the jail began. He was caught multiple times by the police, and on most of the occasions he would escape the jail, leaving the authorities embarrassed. It reached to a point when Umesh would travel to different cities in the country, raping and killing women at will. When a lookout notice was issued against Umesh by the court, he continued raping women, and one of his victims was the wife of an income tax officer. Umesh was finally caught when he was raping a woman who shouted for defense, and the neighbors caught him red-handed. Even then, he was able to make a successful escape after befriending the local police guard, adding to the embarrassment of the police. A final arrest was made in the year 2002 after a rickshaw driver in the Bengaluru city recognized his face. After his arrest from the Yashwantpur railway station, the police found a huge chunk of clothes from his belongings. And it included 18 pairs of panties, 10 bras, 8 churidars, 6 saris, 4 blouses, and 2 nighties. He reportedly wore women's clothes at night while sleeping. After being taken into the custody for good, a total of 18 murder charges were put against him. However, only 9 were backed by strong evidence. A fast-track court sentenced death penalty for Umesh, and this decision was upheld by the higher courts, ignoring his multiple mercy petitions. Umesh wrote mercy petitions to the government of Karnataka and even to the president of India on the grounds of taking care of his old mother, but all of them were denied. A man in uniform who turned a nightmare for many is currently in jail serving his sentence. Police officials suggest that the 53-year-old man would have raped many more women than what it is on record, as several chose to not file a case. Known for his smartness, this former police constable escaped jail 5 times, and that speaks volumes about the seriousness and efforts put in by the authorities to catch him. Being a part of the department, he was well aware of the functioning, and as a result of the same, he used it to the best of his use. On November 4th, 2022, the apex court of the country commuted his death sentence to 30 years imprisonment, out of which 10 years will be of solitary confinement. Do share what you feel about this dreaded criminal from Karnataka and share your thoughts in the comment section below. Share this video and follow NewsHamster on all our social media platforms for more such content.